Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. With the QuickBooks Online Plus plan, you also have the option to use items on your expenses and bill forms. You're probably wondering why you'd want to do that. So watch and we'll walk through some examples. Okay, let's go up here and choose an expense. You would be accustomed to seeing this category section here because this is where you might enter, for example, your rent expense, or office expenses, whatever it is that is the category of expense that you would like it to appear in your income statement. However, if you're using the Plus plan, and particularly if you're using inventory, you have the option to enter in here any items. So look at this drop down here. You can see all of these inventory items are available to select in our expense. The same option is also available when you're entering a bill, something that you'll be paying later. So let's pop up here to bill. Have the category, let's close that one and open up the items. And once again, all of our inventory items are sitting all here waiting to be purchased. Let's have a look at our income statement and our balance sheet to see where things stand right now. And then we'll enter in an item, we'll purchase an item into our inventory. So as you can see, our inventory is sitting at $38,046 with accounts payable at $42,202. So let's go to a bill here. And where will we go? Let's go to Tim Phillip Masonry. Well, look, we've got a purchase order outstanding for him. I'm not going to add that in this particular point in time. I'm going to say I've got a bill because those rock fountains have not yet arrived. So I'm going to buy some rocks from Tim Phillip Masonry, just some plain old garden variety rocks. And let's say we have 500 on hand. Let's grab another 500. We have a big job coming up. Let's say these rocks are $10 each. So that's $5,000 worth of rocks. Let's save and close. So let's pop back now to our profit and loss. As you can see, nothing has changed. We'll go to our balance sheet. Let's refresh. Now we have inventory of $43,046 and accounts payable at $47,202.67. So as you can see, until we sell the items in inventory, they don't impact our profit. They're added into our inventory, added into the amount that we owe. When we sell them, we'll see the income and the cost of goods sold. If you'd like to watch an example on that, check out my video on using inventory in QuickBooks Online.
You may have noticed as we're walking through the example that you can also tag these items as billable to a customer. There's a prior video that walks through an example of how to do that. But with all of these different features, you can pretty much do everything you need for your business, which is super exciting. Oh, if there's anything you want help with anytime, by all means, reach out. Check out the features below and the blog post that outlines all of those different features. Click like, subscribe. I'll see you again soon. Cheers.